Everyone has a plan till the time life punches you in the face. This was said by Das Amanto, who was the first trainer of Mike Tyson, the great boxer Mike Tyson. And how true it is. You know, I have people who come to me with these business plans, so elaborate business plans, and they have absolutely no contingency plan if things go wrong. You know, just to say, one of my students yesterday commented on the video that I love your videos, you know, because they not only relate to business and entrepreneurship, but they relate so much to life as well. And that's predominantly because life is again a journey, just like entrepreneurship. It's just a journey, and we all face the same issues, whether you're an entrepreneur or not an entrepreneur, we all face just the same issues. Okay, so here we go. What should be included in your business plan? The first thing that should be included is this one line. You know, if you go online and check all the business plans that are freely available of all the multinational companies or all the unicorn companies, you will find one thing in common. All these companies had their business plans written down on plain paper. They were just about few sentences, one pagers, that's it. You know, today I think the young entrepreneur spends too much time on making a business plan and strategies rather than executing them, rather than going in business. Wrong way to start a business, actually. Okay, so here is my take on it. What I mean by one line: if you can't explain someone what your business or what your website is or your service in one line, then you got to rethink about your business. Anything you do, how much ever bigger the product is, how much ever bigger the service is, how much ever complicated it is, you should be able to explain it to your customer or your client or your layman in just one line. And that one line should be just few words, maybe 7 to 8 words. That's it. Can you do that? That's the first thing that should be there in your business line, business plan. I just tick mark that for you now. Okay. The second thing what you should include, or what should you know about your business plan, is my product or service any better? And remember, it doesn't have to be unique. Many people get caught up into this thing that my product or my service has to be absolutely unique. No, trust me, it doesn't have to be unique. It has to be just a little better. You can make it unique in the whole process. Right now, when you're starting off, it just have to be a little better than what is existing currently in the market. Right? So the second point here is my product or my service any better? The third point is very important. Do I have competition in the market? Again, many people come and say, oh, there is so much competition in the market. I want to create something which has no competition. If you want to create something which has no competition, then trust me, you should be a millionaire with lots of funds to back it up. When you are a new entrepreneur, go into a market which has some competition so that people are aware of that kind of a solution. People are aware of that kind of a product, correct? And if you can then just little better it, you have a better chance of performing and winning. Rather than going into a market which is very new, people have never heard of it, it's gonna be more difficult for you. Next point, always remember this Murphy's Law, one of my favorite. Okay, now what is the Murphy's Law state? Anything that is gonna go wrong will go wrong. Isn't it wonderful? Okay, and it's not only in business, you know, it can be at your workplace, it can be in your college, it can be in your family, it can be any part of your life. Just remember, always remember this one thing: anything that can go wrong will go wrong. That's how life operates. The question here is, what is your contingency plan? What is your plan B? What steps are you taking to make sure to safeguard yourself? So this is what you should do. Make a list. Make a list of all the things that can go wrong. You're starting a business, make a list of all the things that can go wrong. You're starting a new venture. Make a list of all the things that can go wrong. You're going into a new workplace. Make a list of all the possible hurdles that you will have to face there. You're going to a new course, a new college, a new environment. List down all the things that can possibly go wrong and write down possible solutions to it. And that solutions don't have to be absolutely accurate. It just have to be solutions that you can think about, solutions that can make you confident. Now, making this list is gonna do one more thing. First thing, it's gonna create confidence in the people around you. Your parents are gonna understand, oh look, my son is gonna do this and he knows that these things can go wrong, but he has this plan to solve it, or he has the solutions for it, right? Maybe your husband, your wife, right? You want to tell them that, look, I'm gonna go for entrepreneurship, but these are the things that can go wrong and I have a solution for it. Now, all these things create confidence in the other person. Just imagine from the investor's point of view also. You are presenting him or her your business plan and you say, look, this is my business plan and this is a list of things that can go wrong in our business. But we have this solutions lined up that if this thing goes wrong, this is what we can do. If this thing goes wrong, this is what I'm gonna do. And that's the time when the investor, you know, says that, look, he's the guy I want to invest in. Why? Because you have created confidence in him. For example, when I started off taking these training sessions, after about 2-3 months, taking about 30-40 training sessions, I started realizing there's so many things that go wrong. Just as per Murphy's law, sometimes the mics don't work. You know, sometimes the PPTs don't work. Sometimes, you know, the people come late to the sessions. Now, how do I manage all these things? If the slides don't work, I should have a small little book and a pen, correct, which should have every slide, right? Or maybe a printout of every slide, correct? If the mic is not working, I should make sure that there has to be visual images on my slides, which helps the people to understand what I'm saying. Or rather, I can shout on top of my voice, right? If the training sessions start late, you know, I have to make sure which are the slides that I'm gonna skip, which are the most important slides in my presentation, which is gonna make an impact on my audience, right? So just remember this thing. Point number one, as per Murphy's law, all the things that are supposed to go wrong in life are gonna go wrong. Have solutions ready for it. The solutions don't have to be perfect. And second thing, I love what Das Amanto said. Everyone has a plan till the time life punches them in the face. Thank you so much. All the best. Yeah, man.